Hi, I'm Jason with Cerakote, and today we're going to take you through all the steps needed to successfully apply our C-Series and Glacier Series coatings. This video is intended to accompany the C-Series and Glacier Series training manual found on our website. These coatings are air-cured, ready to spray ceramic coatings that set the industry standard for high temperature performance, withstanding temperatures up to 1800 degrees Fahrenheit. C-Series coatings also offer excellent UV resistance. Because C-Series coatings offer incredible thermal and UV stability, some recommended applications consist of automotive components, such as turbos, exhaust components, and brake calipers, exterior fixtures and decor, which includes outdoor lighting, fire pits, or railings. Cerakote C-Series is also the premier finish for 3D printed parts that cannot be oven cured. Our C-Series coatings may be applied with an HVLP spray gun or pressurized spray system. For general application, we recommend an IWATA LPH-80 with a 0.8mm needle nozzle. Phase 1, Dissassembly. Completely disassemble your project by removing any components that you don't want coated. If you are working with a mechanical part and are unfamiliar with the level of disassembly, refer to the manufacturer or have a trained professional perform the disassembly and reassembly. Phase 2, degrease. From this point on, it is critical to avoid touching the parts with your bare hands. Use powder-free latex or nitrile gloves to handle the parts. All parts must be free from oils and moisture before spraying. Soak metal parts for 20 to 30 minutes in a degreasing chemical such as acetone or brake and parts cleaner. For substrates that are more sensitive to solvents, such as wood or composites, refer to the C-Series training manual for detailed instructions. Phase 3, masking. Begin by plugging and masking off any areas that you do not want coated. Phase 4, sandblasting. Sandblast the parts with 80 to 100 grit aluminum oxide or garnet sand, and adjust the sandblasting pressure between 80 and 100 psi for metal parts. Strive for an even blast pattern over the entire surface of the part. If the part surface remains shiny or uneven after sandblasting, you have not blasted enough. Hand sanding is not recommended, as this will not yield a sufficient profile for optimal coating adhesion. Phase 5, racking. Hang or fixture your parts so that you have optimal coating coverage and part stability. Phase 6, gas out. Optional, but recommended. Please refer to the C-Series training manual for more information and examples of when gas out is needed. Phase 7, coating preparation. Begin by agitating the Cerakote bottle for 5 to 10 minutes until the coating has been thoroughly mixed and no solids remain in the bottom of the container. We recommend a paint shaker for pints, quarts, and gallons. For testers, agitating by hand is sufficient. Filter the desired amount of coating through a mesh strainer into the spray gun cup. Strainer sizes are listed on the bottle label. Lightly tapping the in-cup strainer will assist in straining heavy metallic or high viscosity colors more efficiently. Cleaning equipment. Clean all containers and equipment with acetone or a compatible degreasing solvent. A Cerakote wash bottle and cylinder bottle brush are helpful tools for cleaning. Phase 8, spraying. Blow off the parts with dry compressed air to make sure there is no trapped blasting media in holes, seams, or pockets. Make sure parts are at room temperature before application. For best application results, adjust air pressure settings between 25 and 30 psi. For hard-to-reach areas, adjust your spray gun settings to achieve a 1-inch oval with moderately sized spatter. Adjust the spray gun to achieve a 2 to 3 inch oval fan pattern while spraying from a distance of 3 to 5 inches. Strive for even coverage when spraying. The coating should appear wet. The standard film thickness for Glacier series is 1 mm. For C series, 1 to 2 mm. This thickness can usually be achieved in 1 to 2 wet coats. If the spray gun sits longer than 3 minutes, re-agitation of the coating is recommended. Phase 9, curing schedule. Allow coated parts to air cure. They will be tack-free in approximately 45 to 60 minutes after the application. Until this point, the coating is still wet, so take care not to bump or touch the parts. The coating will be partially cured after 24 hours and can then be handled and removed from fixtures. After 5 days, the coating is fully cured and ready to reassemble for use. This concludes the video application guide. Please refer to the training manual for additional information and feel free to browse the rest of our YouTube channel where we have a library of helpful videos. As always, please reach out to our technical support team at technicalsupport@cerakote.com with any additional questions.